you're in the faith, because so many fall away from it and justify it somehow. They try to. 95% of God's people have done that, and I tell you, it is a plague in this end time on God's church, the greatest plague, because they are making the biggest mistake they could possibly make and need to correct that. Notice verse 38. And I will judge you as women that break wedlock and shed blood are judged. And I will give you blood in fury and jealousy. See, if they break that wedlock, this is serious business to God. He said, I will give them blood in fury and rage. I will give them blood because I am jealous. God is a jealous God. I mean, if we are married to a mate, we ought to be jealous in the right way. God is. He takes it very seriously when He makes a covenant with people. He takes it seriously, and He wants us to take it the same way. It says there, He will judge. He will judge. That's in the future. That's prophecy. It's actually being fulfilled now, even today. This is a book for the end time. It's not a book for ancient Israel. It's not a book about just the history of Israel. It's a book about prophecy for spiritual Israel in the end time. People ought to understand that, but very few do. Verse 43, because you have not remembered the days of your youth, but have fretted me in all these things, behold, therefore, I also will recompense your way upon your head, says the Eternal God, and you shall not commit this lewdness above all your abominations. You see, He said, look, there was a time in your youth when you didn't act this way, but they turned away from what they did in their youth, in another era of God's church. And He says, I'm going to recompense her way upon her head. Again, that's future. That's not past. That's prophecy. Prophecy that should be ringing in our ears now, because it's being fulfilled as I talk, and will continue to be fulfilled right down to the time that Jesus Christ returns to this earth. See, these people forgot what God taught them. Now, where did that happen in this end time? Well, it's not too hard to figure that out. And this booklet on Ezekiel will certainly show you that. Verse 44, behold, everyone that uses proverbs shall use this proverb against you, saying, as is the mother, so is the daughter. Well, who is the mother? Well, that's a type of ancient Israel. Well, who is the daughter? Well, this is spiritual Israel in this end time. And God says, well, just like ancient Israel rebelled against me, so is the daughter. So is the daughter in this end time rebelling. And it's a dual prophecy. Well, it's dual, and the daughter part is prophecy for this end time. And God says, as the mother went into captivity, so is the daughter. We'd better take these words seriously. God is full of rage because of their breaking this covenant. And the others who are rebelling, if they never made the covenant at all. But it's all prophetic. You see, this is not Old Testament. This is for this end time. Verse 59, for thus says the Eternal God, I will even deal with you as you have done, which have despised the oath in breaking the covenant. They broke the covenant. I will deal with you. Again, prophecy for the future. That's not past tense. That's the future. This book of Ezekiel is for this end time. And God wants us to have this most noble reward of being His bride, but the standards are pretty high. After all, if you're going to marry the Son of the living God, you'd surely have to have a pretty high standard. But that's what He's offering you. And if you can believe that, that is, does take faith to even believe it. I tell you, the Bible makes that so clear. You can find many scriptures to support exactly what I'm saying. Verse 60, nevertheless, I will remember your covenant with you in the days of your youth, and I will establish unto you an everlasting covenant. An everlasting covenant, one that lasts for all eternity. I mean, this is not some kind of a small little project we're talking about here. This is everlasting. It's going to last forever. What, isn't that worth giving and committing your life to if it's going to last forever? Verse 61 talks about they will remember me and be ashamed. When you shall receive your sisters, your elder and your younger, and I will give them unto you for daughters, but not for your covenant. And what God is saying is, those that come in after Christ gets here are not going to be on the wife level. They're going to be like the daughters. They're going to be like the children. They're not going to have that noble reward that's given only to the first fruits that come out before Christ's second coming and get themselves ready. Get themselves ready. What an elevated status that is. I mean, it's unparalleled. And even in the Bible, there's only one of that, that's a reward like that. Only one. Now, these are the first fruits, you see, that have to get ready. They have to get ready, and we have to have the vision to see beyond the marriage itself. I mean, it doesn't end when we marry Christ. That is just the beginning. That's when the great work really begins, when Christ gets here, and then we consummate that marriage with Jesus Christ, become His helpmeet, and go out into this world and help Him to teach and bless and make happy all of this earth and its inhabitants. Until next week, this is Gerald Flurry. Goodbye, friends.
Request our two free booklets, Ezekiel, The End Time Prophet, and Why Marriage? Soon Obsolete? The prophet Ezekiel will have lived in vain if God's true church doesn't proclaim his message today. The book of Ezekiel is clearly an end time message. It reveals specific prophetic events that are happening right now in the United States, Britain, and many other English-speaking nations. Ezekiel also reveals that these nations are headed for the worst crisis ever known. But it's all part of God's master plan to usher in the wonderful kingdom of God. Herbert W. Armstrong taught the prophecies of Ezekiel in a general way for many years, but now, for the first time, they are fully revealed to you through this exciting book. Request Ezekiel, the End Time Prophet. Also request Why Marriage? Soon Obsolete? Is Marriage on the Way Out? Is Adultery Still Wrong? Is the institution of the home with its family life to disappear from society? How and when did the institution of marriage originate? Does it, after all, serve any necessary purpose? This booklet takes an in-depth look at the institutions of marriage, the home, and family life, and reveals a startling, even shocking truth which has been altogether overlooked by science, by religion, by education, and by society. Request Why Marriage? Soon Obsolete? You'll also be sent a free subscription to our news magazine, The Philadelphia Trumpet. The Trumpet continues to look at today's headlines through the clear light of Bible prophecy. With world events speeding out of control, never before has a news magazine been so important for you to read. Your free subscription is waiting. Please also visit us online at thetrumpet.com for daily columns and headlines. Request our two free booklets, Ezekiel, The End Time Prophet, and Why Marriage? Soon Obsolete, along with the Trumpet magazine. Request your free literature now. For the free literature, click on the Request menu option.